Això és molt raro, eh? Vull dir, estem a un lloc així com... una mica estrany. Acompanya'm, Jordi, que ets l'única persona que conec en aquest ambient tan raro. Mira quina columna, Jordi. Això és caro, eh? Aquí hi ha diners, eh? Jordi, aquí hi ha molts diners. Hi ha cables pel terra, Jordi, eh? Acompanya'm, acompanya'm, Jordi, perquè... ens espera un sofà estupendo. D'un color així com... bueno, groc. Evidentment, no, perquè és un color molt groc. Jo m'asseuré perquè estic una mica cansat i baldat del dia d'avui. Vine, Jordi. Vine, Jordi, perquè hem de saludar a tothom aquí, eh? Perquè, hola a tots, estem al primer live experience, experience meaning wear shirts i paraules en anglès. Estem al primer esdeveniment en viu en Facebook del Catalunya Experience. Hola a todo el mundo que nos está viendo desde el resto de España. ¿Qué tal? Hello, everybody who has seen us through the world because we have here today Freddy Krueger, Robert Englund. I és veritat, si manteneu l'anglès, avui tenim amb nosaltres a Robert Englund. Però abans que això, presentarem la segona temporada del Catalunya Experience que començarà el 5 d'octubre a TV3, els dimecres a la nit. Toma! Ai, envalentonaos, eh? Avui, això, tindrem a una de les persones més emblemàtiques de l'univers del terror aquí amb nosaltres, perquè també estarà al Catalunya Experience. Però, si és cert que si hem de començar a comprendre de què anirà aquesta segona temporada, ens hem de posar en context. Així que, quin millor context en aquest univers que la Ivana Minyó, que la tinc a la meva esquerra. Ivana.
Hola, Adrià, què tal?
Et tinc a l'esquerra. Ha sigut molt misteriós.
Sí,
sí, ha sigut misteriós.
He aparegut així com així.
És que és l'univers del terror, una mica el que explorem avui en aquest streaming. És com que una mica raro tot això,
sí, eh? Sí, jo et veig amb una espiral de por que m'estàs contagiant una mica, eh?
Sí?
També? Sí, sí.
Bueno, què hem de fer? Tu coneixes tècniques de respiració per estar
sí.
més...
A veure... Però són molt complicades, jo te les ensenyaré després. Ah. És igual, deixa que passin les coses i ja ens anirem relaxant.
Estupendo.
Sí.
Catalunya Experience, segona temporada. Encara esteu immersos a les gravacions.
Sí. Encara ens queden uns quants dies de rodatge, acabar aquest capítol que estem fent ara i l'últim que ens quedarà després de la tornada de les vacances, de l'estiu. Ja n'hem fet uns quants, ja en portem uns quants a l'esquena.
Ja portem uns quants. Sí. I com és el balanç? Així com ho estàs veient? Quines diferències hi ha entre la primera temporada i
doncs,
aquesta segona?
Anem més a fondo, encara és més intens, els capítols encara són més intensos, tenim convidats que són genials, l'any passat també ho eren, aquest any també tenim molt... no, potser el perfil no és tant d'instagramers només, sinó viatgers com sempre, però de molts mons diferents, gent que viatja amb autostop, gent, una parella de jubilats que viatja fent feina social, bueno, ho sé, i moltes sorpreses. Una escriptora de la guia de la Lonely Planet, i bueno, convidats molt interessants.
Bueno, de cinc puntes diferents, com sempre. O sigui...
Com sempre, d'arreu del món. Sí.
Molt bé.
Sí, sí.
A veure, una de les persones que tindrem aquí en aquest sofà també amb nosaltres dintre d'una estoneta, sota el hashtag Freddy Catalunya Experience TV3, ja ens podeu enviar les preguntes pel Robert Englund, no ho oblideu, serà aquest, el Robert Englund. És com el convidat estrella de la temporada.
Bueno, tots són estrelles,
tots són estrelles.
A pesar que aquesta estrella és molt coneguda per molta gent arreu del món. Ara mateix estem gravant amb ell, portem ja uns 5-6 dies, i està sent una setmana apassionant.
Sí.
Més que res, perquè també ell s'apassiona amb tot. Per tant, tu també t'apassiones de tot. És una persona molt entusiasta, que sempre està preguntant, que és molt curiosa. I sí, avui ens queda un dia de rodatge només amb ell. Fa molta pena.
Un dia de rodatge
sí.
només?
Sí.
Ai,
sí.
Ja s'acaba, això.
Sí, ja s'acaba.
Però tu ja el coneixies abans, no, el
sí.
Robert Englund?
Sí, sí, ens vam conèixer, vam fer una pel·li junts fa uns quants anys i hem seguit en contacte. Jo vaig anar a visitar amb ell i la seva dona a Califòrnia fa uns 3 anys i sí, mantenim el contacte.
Que bé.
És molt fàcil amb gent com ell.
Sí, no? Perquè té la fama d'una persona bastant molt social, molt propera, no?
Sí, sí. Sí, o sigui, té la imatge aquella
té la imatge que
tenim tots gravats a la retina, no? De que no ens va deixar dormir durant molts anys. Però sí, és una persona molt... Bueno, també era també el Lagarto Bueno de UB, vull dir que també, per un altre cantó. Sí, el Willy era un tros de pa.
Era un tros de pa.
Però després el Freddy va esborrar tota la memòria.
I com és veure Catalunya? Tu que ja te la coneixes, Catalunya, eh? Però com és veure Catalunya a través dels ulls del Robert Englund, un personatge tan característic?
Home, ens passen tots els convidats, però amb el Robert, que és especialment entusiasta de tot, curiós, culte, té molta informació de tot i sempre està preguntant i sempre vol anar més enllà, doncs és com redescobrir-ho tot i tornar-te a emocionar, no? A través dels ulls d'un nen, perquè és com molt... És molt nen en aquest sentit,
sí.
En el bon sentit de la paraula, sí.
Sí, que bé. I tu has pogut dormir? Vull dir, tenint en compte que, clar, has tingut uns dies de gravació, tu no has tingut por d'anar-te a dormir pel tema de malsomnis i tot això?
No, jo el que porto tota la setmana intentant espantar-lo amb ell, perquè m'ho he proposat, i no ha sigut possible.
No?
No. O sigui, sí, se m'ha tret el son de no poder trobar la manera de sorprendre aquesta persona. Però bueno, no passa res. Encara em queda un dia de rodatge.
Wow. Bueno, encara estàs a temps, eh? Jo t'animo profundament.
Sí, però no és fàcil, no és fàcil sorprendre'l.
No és fàcil? Bueno, tu com vivies aquestes pel·lícules de petitona? Tu te'n recordes?
Home, sí, me'n recordo... mira, si sóc sincera, jo era més de Jason. El Jason amb...
Era més a Jason?
Sí, sí, sí.
Ets una infidel.
Ja, ja, bueno, perquè no sé per què, és allò que quan ets petit no decideixes, no tries massa les pel·lis que veus, no? O sigui, et trobes amb el que et trobes, i jo sí que vaig tenir un trauma amb una escena de Jason que s'anava a dormir una persona en un càmping o una...
Planada de marranada.
Sí, sí, llavors vaig estar, crec que un estiu, mirant sota el llit.
Uf.
Sí, sí, però si hagués vist una pesadilla en Elm Street m'hagués passat el mateix amb el Freddy, vull dir que...
Mare meva.
Sí.
Bueno, tu ja te'l coneixes, el Robert.
Uh-huh.
Jo intentaré cridar-lo, perquè m'han dit que està per aquí, però jo encara no l'he vist.
Sí, en teoria, bueno, ens hem de veure perquè estem d'aquí, res, mitja horeta, quan acabem amb tu ja comencem a rodar.
Vaja.
I ens havíem citat aquí, però no apareix. Doncs,
pues, bueno, a tu tampoc t'havies aparèixer, així que tinc sort, a veure si...
Sí, potser també...
A veure si... Robert, ja pots venir, Robert. Que t'estan esperant els teus fans, Robert.
Vols que t'ajudi?
Robert. Ivana, tu que, jo què sé, tu,
sí, sí, ja,
si vols cridar-lo tu...
Robert! Home, m'ho has de dir en anglès.
Ah, Art.
Robert!
Robert. Ivana, bé, tranquil·la, tu, tranquil·la, tu has d'estar tranquil·la, no passa res,
d'acord?
Perquè tu...
Hola, Ivana! Ciao!
Ciao! Se'n va? Bé? Robert!
You're incorrigible, you're like a child.
You're too much fun to scare.
No, you sit here, you sit, you're good.
What?
Oh. There's better, closer to him, closer to him.
Closer to me?
A little shave.
Yeah, you want to shave me. Robert, how are you?
I'm good, I'm great.
You're great.
I just enjoy scaring her so much.
Yeah, she told me that it's impossible to... She wants to terrify you, but it's impossible.
He's always terrifying me.
Oh my God.
I torture her in movies, and I scare her on the Catalonia experience.
Wow. We are actually right now under the hashtag FreddyCataluniaExperienceTV3. You want to say hi to all the people who is watching you?
Right. Hello, everybody. Hi.
Hi. They are sending questions right now at this very moment, so we are all stressed.
Okay, I'm ready. I'm ready.
Are you ready?
Ask me anything, aficionados.
I'm going to bomb you with questions.
Okay. Oh my God, he's going to drink water.
Yes.
Okay, the question is about water. The question that I'm going to make to you, okay? Because people, when you are a tourist, they're usually... You swim between sharks and dolphins, but you swim in a mitja de mar between tunas. How was that? Is weird? Is that weird as it sounds?
She made me swim with the fishies. No, it was great. Actually, once you're in the water, it's very spiritual because you see them down deep below you. And they're so beautiful. But when they put the bait fish, the little mackerel, the sardines.
I was throwing them into.
You were fishing them.
So
I'm swimming peacefully, zen, looking at the massive tuna, the kings of the sea. And then Ivana is up throwing these little fish, and they hit here. Then the tuna come up, and they grab it, and they're as big as the end of the couch where I'm sitting.
Yeah.
No exaggeration.
Yeah. They're like. Like this, something like this, and like this, this big.
Wow.
Yeah, huge, big. And they move as fast as a car.
Whoosh, whoosh. Yeah, I could see it from, jo podia veure des de dalt, i era impressionant. But the way they...
We say in the States, I'm sure you have an equivalent expression in Catalan, you turn on a dime, you turn on a corner.
Sí, que en l'últim moment les tonyines feien
xum,
i esquivaven el Robert, però anaven directes cap al peix. Sí, sí.
But they're designed, I mean, God made them, nature made them perfect for their environment.
Wow, there was fear, so...
Fear and beauty, beauty and fear.
Okay.
You know, zen, one moment zen, the next minute terror.
We have a question from a fan, from a Facebook page called Kruger Tales from Elm Street, so there is a fan base that exists. And would you ever endorse Roberto Lombardi as your successor? Wow.
Robert Lombardi is my successor. I wouldn't wish that horrible makeup process on anyone. Yeah.
How many hours was it?
Cuatro para camera. Tres y media, cuatro para camera. Con contact lenses, con mis ojos, and the teeth, fake teeth. When I have all of that, for, and I'm ready for my, I'm ready for my close-up when no, I have all that 4 hours
yeah. Wow.
For a close-up, yeah.
Brilliant.
And when I wear the body makeup,
yeah,
that's 5-7 hours.
Wow.
Cinco a siete. And when I did Phantom of the Opera,
yeah,
5 hours.
Really?
And I did a Stephen King movie, Se llama Le Mangler, El Mangler. And I was an old man. I played very old.
Yeah.
And that makeup was five hours too. Yeah.
Wow. Well,
yeah, usually it's 1 hour. Well, for we women, it's yeah. 1 hour. Tops.
Yeah.
No, I don't know. I think Ivana takes a little longer.
No. I don't need makeup. Come on.
Well.
No. She glows from within.
But after this five, after these 5 hours, then you wake up flawless and you say, "Here I am."
The process
yeah.
is a pain in the, and it is. And by the time it's done, I'm kind of in a bad mood. So I'm sort of halfway to Freddy already in character because they've been poking me all morning.
Yeah.
You know, 4 or 5 in the morning, they've been working on me to get me ready. Yeah. And you're in a bad mood.
Yeah, it was like, let me sleep.
And if I had a makeup man that liked the same kind of music, great. But sometimes my makeup men were, you guys understand, headbangers, heavy metal.
Okay.
You know, oh my God. Yeah, I needed something a little more mellow in the morning.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Wow, wow, wow. Well, you have visited the cemetery of Montjuic. Have you seen any of your victims, of your hundreds of victims there, or?
Well, you know, that is such a beautiful cemetery.
Yeah.
It's so beautiful. And facing the sea, that it's as much about life and beauty as it is about death.
Hmm.
Because the attention to the landscaping, Los Árboles,
hmm.
the artists that have built and the architects that have designed the crypts and the mausoleums, as well as the simple graves. It's so beautiful in a way that you don't think about death as much as some cemeteries I've been to.
Hmm.
So I didn't really, you know, of course we were there in the afternoon, durante
las tardes, yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. We weren't there at night. At night,
maybe?
It might be a very different experience, you know.
Yeah.
Maybe I would see, you know what Freddy says?
Yeah.
Cada pueblo tiene un Elm Street.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that there's probably an Elm Street somewhere in Barcelona, so I probably have some victims stashed here.
Wow. Wow, ara mateix, en aquest precís instant, tenim un munt de gent connectada veient aquesta experiència en viu des de Facebook. Hello, there is a lot of people watching us right now at this very moment. You know it?
I know they're out there. I know they're out there. They're my Elm Street brats, my next victims.
You're searching for them? You've seen a lot of victims here in Catalunya.
I'm getting hungry. I need some.
Okay.
Freddy needs a refill.
Okay, well, I'm saying goodbye. I'm saying goodbye. Recordeu el hashtag que estem sota Freddy Catalunya Experience TV3, aquí perquè escriviu les vostres preguntes en tots els idiomes possibles. Bueno, no el truqueu, que és car. Call me? Call me.
Oh. Call me.
What do you prefer, a call or a write or a letter?
I get art.
Oh.
People are inspired, young children too, are inspired by some of the images. The claw, the hat, sombrero,
yeah.
The red and green, verde y roja.
Yeah.
Stripes on the sweater, and so the children send me drawings, and I love them. I love getting those in the mail. Yeah.
Okay. We have another question.
Ah.
Yeah, we have another question because we have a lot of people taking. Oh my God, asking questions. They are so, they're boring us. Oh. Okay. Another question comes from Abdi Fernandez. We can escribe this on Facebook. I am Ziu. Sure, you had a wild night at Las Santas of Mataró.
Oh.
Yeah. It was a wild day.
It was another attempt of mine to scare him. But then I got scared of the fireworks, and he was like excited like a little baby. So yeah, he got a great
As it got later and later,
yeah,
I felt younger and younger.
Wow.
And the rhythm of the band and the music and the energy from all the young people at the festival, it started to affect me. I think because she's been working so hard, she was getting a little more tired. I got, what do they call it? In America, we call it the second wind.
yeah.
of energy. I got my second wind of energy. And it was just amazing. And our producers on the Catalonia Experience, they had all through the procession, through the streets, they had these balconies reserved, private homes, certain places that were for the culture people. And we were able to go into them and get these great vantage points of the street.
And it was like the family.
One giant snake of people. Wow. It, the way the movement of the bodies of all of the people. Amazing, just amazing.
Sí, és una nit bastant impressionant, la de les Santes, alguna així, és brutal. I amb la perspectiva que vam veure ahir i jo...
Clar, teníeu tot el sanitat, això.
Exacte, i veus la magnitud de la festa i és al·lucinant. Sí, estan molt bojos els mataronins.
Ivana and our producer, Xavi and I, we would be in the front, you know, going, all of a sudden, here we go, knock, 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 Xavi would knock on the door. And these people were there, and they'd already reserved this house, and it would be like... Hola, Freddy, come in. We'd all walk in, you know? And they would be into the party.
Oh. Yeah, they were.
But it was great. But then you'd get to the windows, and it was the perfect view because our cameramen had helped choose these perfect homes and balconies and vantage points throughout the parade. Oh, it was great. Yeah.
Yeah, and to feel the energy of thousands of people like jumping at the same time.
But in between in the little plazas. Placitos, little plaza, I don't know.
Placitas.
In the little ones, when the fireworks go off, they echo, you know, boom, boom, boom off of the buildings. So it's twice as loud. And I got too close to one. So I was like not even hearing out of one ear at midnight. You know, I was already, you know.
Wow. Bueno. A Metge de Mar, Nou Apuntant, al cementiri de Montjuïc, a Mataró, bueno, està tot arreu, aquí, al Robert England, en 5 dies, eh? Catalunya Experience, a l'octubre. Continueu enviant-nos preguntes perquè continuem llançant-li preguntes. Freddy, Catalunya Experience TV3. Tinc una altra. Això
no s'acaba. But as we sit here, that festival is still going on. Right
yeah,
now.
Yeah.
It's still going on, yeah.
Nosaltres vam anar la primera nit, que era dilluns, però...
Check it out.
El Robert anava dient, però què faran la segona nit? I l'última? Si això ho fan la primera nit, què passarà l'última?
Com acabarà això?
Like your question, like...
I know, I thought it was the last night. I didn't think
it was
the
first
night. How do they top that? I just want to go back just to see what they're going to do tomorrow night.
Catalonian blood.
What are they doing? Friday, Viernes?
Yeah, I think...
What are they going to do on Friday night?
Tomorrow's the last night.
You can imagine. You won't imagine. We have another question from Ivani Miguel from Ultramundo Blog through her Facebook page, and they ask, when you made the new Nightmare on Elm Street, you made a different role inside the same character. How did you manage it?
Well, the idea by Wes Craven for Nueva Pesadilla was that what if Freddy really was real? That it was based on a true story, and if he was an essence of evil, and now he was mad, that Hollywood was exploiting him. So we all played ourselves and we made fun of each other. We made fun of ourselves like Robert England, Estrella, you know. And so we made fun of ourselves, but we teased Hollywood a little bit too. Okay. And then at one point, I am a kind of, in German they would say, Uber Freddy. An exaggeration of Freddy, a super Freddy, So that was just, you know, I just got to wear a really cool bodysuit, fake muscles, and black leather pants like I was in The Doors, like Jim Morrison.
Okay. Let's have a question. But to you, Catalunya is
magic. More than anything, it's magic. And it's magic architecture, it's magic countryside, tierra, it's magic people, and I've come to find out it's magic food. But it's a very magical place. The light, you guys have more sky because of the sea, and your buildings aren't so tall, so it's more human scale. So the light comes in through the trees and on the Gaudi buildings and and the size of your streets and the size of the boulevards and the corners just call to people to be outside. They just beckon people to be outside, and you see everyone. You see all kinds of people all the time. And then you get out of the hustle and bustle of Barcelona, and then it's like the sea, the mountains, the countryside, and it's just, it's more tranquil and beautiful. And for me, this on this trip, I learned so much, and very surprising. I always knew Barcelona. I always knew Sitges.
Of course.
But for me to go through Besalú, and I'm going to say it wrong, Matamor. To go to these new places was such a treat, such a gift. Yeah.
Yeah.
Cool.
Wow.
And I got to visit the too.
Well, thank you so much. But before end this, I want to learn something from you, Robert.
Okay.
Okay. I want to be the next Freddy Krueger. In my case, Adrian Krueger. I want you to teach me how to be Freddy Krueger.
Are you sure?
I don't know. I really want to
do
it.
Are you ready for this?
I think I'm so ready.
All right.
Yep. Let's
you have to be part of this now. Because yes, you will be the beautiful ingenue.
Oh,
the
impossible.
Freddy victim from Nightmare One. So your name is Nancy.
Nancy.
Como mi esposo.
Okay.
And will sit on my lap.
Really?
All right, and I will do the lines,
you
need to match the lines when I
say
them.
I'm scared.
Okay, she will be the big Tim.
You know what? This famous scene is the one where Nancy gets a phone call from Freddy, so we need
your phone. Yeah.
Do you have a phone?
Farem una escena, un tutorial de com es fa això, eh?
Com,
oh my God. Okay, so is this hard? How do you...
I think it's me. Now I want you to sit, you sit on my lap.
Okay, that's so exciting, no?
Got the phone.
You got the phone? Okay.
All right, here we go.
There we go.
All right. So? And
any kind of face or
no. Here we go. This will be your hand. You put this hand back here.
Okay.
And this is your hand. Now on you put the phone to your ear. Ring 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 ring.
Hello.
One two.
Hello. Who's there?
I'm your boyfriend now, Nancy. How did you do?
Yeah.
Did you feel the power?
Yeah, I want to be in the setting right now.
I wish I could have seen him. Okay.
What we needed, though, is in the original, the tongue comes out and kisses her.
It
goes,
I remember.
Oh, well, that's visual effects. We don't have this money
right now. We don't have the tongue.
No. We don't.
Maybe some sushi down the street here.
Okay, perfect. Well, aquí tenim una recreació per si voleu ser Freddy Krueger a la vostra vida diària, perquè això és així. La gent voldrà ser Freddy Krueger, no?
Sí.
A la seva vida diària, imagino. Bueno, ara ens hem d'acomiadar. Do you want to say something to all the people that I have seen you through Freddy Catalunya Experience TV3?
Well, I know people are watching from all over, but just to my new friends in Catalonia, I just want to thank you for being so gracious and hospitable to me. And you all live in paradise, and you know it.
Okay.
I tu vols dir alguna cosa, Ivana, ja que estàs també? Va, vinga, animem-nos. A tota la gent que s'està veient des del Facebook.
Doncs que no us perdeu els nous capítols del Catalunya Experience a partir de l'octubre.
Uh-huh.
I no només el del Robert, que serà genial, sinó tots els altres, perquè tenim molt a aprendre de molta gent.
Això és així. Catalunya Experience, això com has dit tu, començarà l'octubre a TV3, eh? Segurament el 5 d'octubre, tots els dimecres. A partir d'aquí, totes les nits, d'acord? Moltíssimes gràcies, Ivana.
Thank
you so much, Robert.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. It has been incredible. Muchas gracias a todos los que nos habéis visto desde el Facebook, ¿eh? Desde el Facebook de Catalunya Experience, seguid a Catalunya Experience en Facebook y en Twitter también, y seguidnos a todos los que estamos aquí también. Thank you so much to everybody who has seen us in this... he wants a call, so call Robert Englund. Moltes gràcies a tothom. Adeu. Adeu.
Adeu.
Adeu.